I was born in India. India received its independence in 1947, a year before Israel. I was born in the year 1967, the year that occupation began. But I first read Anne Frank when I was 12. I became obsessed with the Holocaust. I then became obsessed with every book written about the creation of Israel. I began to see Israel as the dream country, the Ourtopia, which stood not just for freedom and justice for the Israeli or the Jewish people, but for justice and freedom in the world. It was in 1985, when I left India for the first time, that I heard the other side of the story as well. For every Israeli and Jewish friend, I had Palestinian friends as well, and I began to see what was unraveling in this part of the world. One of my dearest, dearest friends is a survivor of the Holocaust from Prague. She was my mentor, my guide, and I learned so much from her about how to deal with injustice and transform the suffering and pain into light and strength. She taught me, todo obscuridad tiene un punto de luz. Every darkness contains a point of light. Her name was Vera Cohn. She died in Ecuador at the age of 100 after having taught, counseled people everywhere around the world. Today, I'm dedicating this performance to the search for justice, dignity, humanity, and freedom in Palestine.
To share my story, because it is unique, born of the pain in our holy land, divided, occupied, and cut into pieces again and again. I am stepping out of the shadows to share my story, for it is not unique, but the same as people everywhere. The same despair and defiance flows in our veins. The same determination makes us rise again. This is how we are transforming the paradigm of power for the future. I am Rauda. I am from Palestine. I was born in 1948 when my country lost its freedom. But I drank the milk of freedom the moment I came out of my mother's breast. When I was 16, I tried to make my first Molotov cocktail, but it exploded in my face instead. I spent 8 years in jail. When they released me, I met Mohammed. He had been their captive for 12 years. His body was ruined with torture. But his soul still burned with the fire of freedom which forged our love. So, we neglected his Muslim parents and my Christian parents, and we married, and we never looked back. As we escaped from one place to the other with our clandestine posters, fighting our occupiers, until the second Intifada. I looked around at the shards of broken lives scattered everywhere. I asked myself, who will help these broken women and children? Who will guide them on the path from suffering to strength? I knew I would.
على هذه الأرض ما يستحق الحياة.
I teach at the Hebrew University. The other day, when I arrived in my office, my colleague said to me, Nadira, you look pale. What's the matter? I said to her, it's those demolition trucks. I saw them again today at sunrise. They make me sick. She looked at me with genuine innocence and said, what demolition trucks? Why? I was dumbfounded. When I got my breath again, I said, don't you know? Can't
Can't you see? Look! Open the window and look! There! 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 What are those? Don't you know? Don't you know how they refuse to allow us to repair our houses until they fall into disrepair? Then they issue demolition certificates saying that our houses are unfit to live in. Don't you know that they give us a choice? Destroy your house yourself, the house that your forefathers built hundreds of years ago, or we will do it for you. Just give us 50,000 shekels. It's not our fault. It's the command from the government. You see, we need your land to build our settlements, to build another peace park, to build another monument for tolerance for our pilgrims and our tourists. Don't you know how we are a plaything in their hands, how our identity is controlled by them, how we are monitored from birth to death, from the maternity ward to the graveyard? Don't you know how they control our movements, how they surveil our entire bodies in the checkpoints, in the prisons, even in our beds. This is the political economy of our everyday. This is the invisibility of our pain. This is how they evict us, exile us, imprison us, execute our children in broad daylight. Now you know, don't ever claim innocence again.
كتابات أسخيليوس أول الحب عشب على حجر أمهات يقفن على خيط ناي وخوف الغزاة من الذكريات على هذه الأرض ما يستحق الحياة.
I am Indisa. I am the mother of a martyr. They killed my son. All my five other sons have also been in jail. We live in the old town. The soldiers are always coming into our house and evicting us and threatening to demolish our home. My husband is very old. What must we do when they throw us out into the street in the middle of the night? He is disabled. He cannot walk. We mothers of martyrs. We created an organization to demand that they return the bodies of our sons. More than 300 of our sons' bodies are in their jails, just a number without even a name. For long, they ignored us. But now, they cannot ignore us anymore. The other day, they returned 30 bodies. I went rushing to see if my son was there. For 4 years, I could not sleep because my heart was full of suffering. One night, I don't know how, I began to write a poem to express all my feelings. Whenever there is a function of our organization, they invite me to recite a poem, because my poems share the feelings of everyone in our community. My son, Jamal, he was only 24. He was so kind. He was so handsome. All I want is to see his face one more time.
غيمٌ يقلد سربا من الكائنات هتافات شعب لمن يصعدون إلى حتفهم باسمين وخوف الطغاة من الأغنيات
I am Rana from Palestine. I am an artist. I work with paintings, with sculpture, with performance art. And
I am active in the streets with my people. We artists of Palestine, we have a duty to record what is happening in our streets. We must record what is happening to our society with our art. Art is my life, and my life is art. I have a noble purpose. It is to fight for dignity and freedom for all our people, because it is dignity which unites us. I don't want to exhibit in some museum in New York. I want to be with my people side by side. We must all fight together to free our country. Art is the most lethal weapon of resistance, but art is the most civilized way.
على هذه الأرض سيدة الأرض أم البدايات أم النهايات.
I am Fauzia from Hebron. I am 30 years old. I am the first in my whole family and in my whole village to fight for my freedom, to get my right to education, and to fight for the freedom of our people. My father was a shepherd. He was too poor to send me to school. So I worked many jobs, tending sheep, raising hens, taking care of the fields, until I could save enough money to go to school. When I had the money, I went and asked my parents to give me permission to go to a village near Hebron so I could be educated. My family said, "We won't let you go alone. We will all come with you." So all 12 of us lived in a small room near Hebron, and I continued my education. I studied psychology in university. All my brothers and sisters after me also went to school and got educated. After university, I started working in Hebron with the women who are traumatized by the violence of occupation. I work in counseling them, and I train them to become community leaders so they can stand for their rights. My dream is that men and women work together to shape new laws for equality and justice. You see, my story and my message is that being distinguished and creative is not limited to your financial means. I want to end this performance and open the dialogue with this photograph of these children that Zahira and I met just yesterday in Jericho, outside the school of UNRWA, of the refugee camp. Because this is the future of Palestine and the future of the world. And these children are laughing, dancing, playing together to create a new future for Palestine and for the whole world. Thank you.